Let's all play What's My Line? And now, let's meet this week's What's My Line panel. First, a charter member of the TV Comedians Hall of Fame, Soupy Sales.
Thank you, and thank you, Johnny Olson. Well, she's back, and we got her. It's Anita Gillette.
Soup, that was the fastest introduction I think you've ever done.
Everybody knows really? That you're beautiful and talented.
Oh, thank you very much. Now here's a beautiful and talented person, too. I've been enjoying sitting next to him on the panel because he's such a nice fellow and a snappy dresser. Mr. Jim Backus.
Thanks for that eulogy. George Jessel. And now that very sexy milkmaid, Miss Arlene Francis.
Thank you very much, Jimmy. And here's our darling moderator, Wally Bruner.
Thank you, Arlene, and welcome everyone to What's My Line. We have some interesting people in store for you with unusual occupations. Are you telling jokes already?
No, they would refer to Arlene as a milkmaid and...
No, but this costas dress is, has a rural flavor, wouldn't you say?
I'm a rural type.
That's right, you are.
And Anita asked me if I'd ever milked a cow, and I said I once worked on a farm milking cow. Pulled down about $1,000 a week.
Oh... Let's meet our
five knots and everything.
That's right.
Let's meet our first challenger. So will you enter and sign in, please?
And one thing led to another.
What?
Michael Hancock. Mr. Hancock, where are you from?
California.
Oh.
All right. Panel, Michael Hancock performs a service. Let's show the audience what his line is. So it's a service you're after, and we'll begin with Arlene.
Thank you, Wally. Mr. Hancock, are you associated in any way with the motion picture business?
Yes.
Are you ever seen on screen?
No.
One down, Mr. Sales.
So what you do, Mr. Hancock, is behind the scenes, behind the scenes, like, in the area of, like, makeup and technician or cameraman, something like
that. Yes, in that area.
In that area. Well, when you do this service, do you ever touch anybody?
Yes.
Do you, when you touch them, do you both sexes?
Yes.
Or do you touch them above the waist?
Sometimes.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yes. What do you touch them? Say from the neck up.
Yes.
Do you ever? Do you indeed put makeup on them?
Yes.
Are you a makeup man?
Right.
I mean.
Soupy, he is indeed a Hollywood makeup artist, and I was going to let you continue because I thought if you went at it long enough, you'd foul it up and get a no.
That's why Anita was standing by.
I was going to say body makeup. There's a very strict rule out there about applying makeup to the face as to other parts of the body.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm. Am I right?
Yes. Mm-hmm. The body makeup classification is for women.
Yeah.
Below the.
Well, for me too. I did a Roman picture, and that makeup man with that cold sponge in the morning.
You know, you had to wear body makeup.
Yeah. Oh, from the legs? Are you kidding?
Under his toga. Oh,
you know, Jim.
You peaked.
But Michael is one of Hollywood's top makeup artists, and is currently in town to promote Max Factor's Femme Fatale movie star look. Now, what is Femme Fatale? What kind of look?
Well, femme fatale is kind of a ratio of today's now look with the look of the silent era of the 20s and 30s in a more defined manner.
You mean the bow mouth and things like that?
Well, it's still a relationship between the two. It's not quite a severe look. It's more definite and more refined, but it does reflect on our ladies of the silver screen.
Have now, to refresh our memories of just a bit of what the movie Silver Screen Queens used to look like of 30 or 40 years ago, Michael has brought with him some interesting film. So why don't we take a look at it while he explains.
What we have here are some of the ladies of the early times. This young lady here. Here is Mae Murray.
Beast on.
And Debbie Daniels. You'll notice the eyebrows and the lips in most of these film clips. There's Dolores Del Rio.
She still looks terrific.
She looks right now.
Don't you love that acting with a face?
Yeah.
Oh, Negri. Rudolph Valentino on one of his early.
People take me for him all the time.
Who's that?
Notice again the play of the eyes. Here we have Claudette Colbert.
Claudette, what's his name?
Barbara Stanwyck. And of course, Marlena Dietrich. And Garbo. One of the most beautiful ladies of all time. Marlowe. Gloria Swanson. And Katharine Hepburn.
Oh, the Calla-Lily.
Carol Lombard. Betty Davis. And here we have Joan Crawford and Sadie Thompson. Hedy Lamarr.
Well, how does the femme fatale look compared with what we just saw?
Well, let me show you. We have our young lady, Audrey, here, wearing a dress created for this particular occasion, the Clara Bow look, by Donald Brooks. In the makeup, you'll notice the eyebrows, the subtleness of the eyes, the rouge was quite different, and also the Cupid doll type lip.
Very nice and very becoming. Thank you, Audrey. Michael, may I say you've tickled our memory quite a bit because you brought back a lot of nostalgia just looking at that film.
And oh, thank you.
If we can accomplish the same thing with making ladies look a bit like that, I think you'll be a success.
Mm-hmm. That's
thank
what we're trying so to do.
We enjoyed having you on.
What's My Line? We'll continue right after this word.
Bring back some memories, gang?
Oh, absolutely. I love the way those ladies
look. Fellas, did you like the look then, the makeup look then, better than now?
I thought, Arlene and I were commenting, who was it looked just like now? Was it Dolores Costello? And her?
Dolores Del Rio.
Del Rio and Carol Lombard, Bart, I thought, looked just like the way...
girls do today,
yeah.
Pretty much. Yeah. If they're pretty, that is.
If they're pretty.
Because those are two beauties.
All right, let's meet another challenger now, and I think you'll find this one pretty. So will you enter and sign in, please? Pat Rondo. And Mrs. Rondo, where are you from?
I'm from Cornwall, England.
All right, now living, though?
In Miami.
In Miami, Florida. All right, panel, Pat Rondo is one of the largest importers in the country of a certain product. Let's show the audience what that product is. So I'll tell you and remind you again that she imports a product, and we'll begin with Soupy Sales.
Thank you. Miss Rondo, this product that you import, is it an edible or drinkable product?
Yes.
Oh, well, let's see. Is it something that you drink?
No.
One down, Anita.
Go.
Then I assume that it's something you eat.
You can.
You can eat it.
Yes.
Oh, all right.
It has other uses, but one of its uses is to eat.
Oh, it has other uses besides eating. Mm-hmm. Okay, is this something I could hold in my hand?
Yeah.
Does it come in a container of some sort?
No, not necessarily.
No. Uh-huh. Well, no, not really. Two down, Jim.
Miss Rondeau, would you say that this comes under the heading of exotic fare?
Yes.
I mean, other...
You mean if you're going to eat it, would it be considered exotic fare? Yes.
If you're going to eat it, couldn't wear it, or we're in big trouble.
What other...
You could pass. Is it something that you would serve as a canapé rather than the main course? Conversation piece?
No. Three down, Arlene.
You say it has other uses apart from the business of being eaten. Is that correct?
Yes.
Does it have a shell?
No.
Four down, Soupy.
Does it have, is it a fur-bearing type of a... What else could you do with a... You could dance with it. I danced with a donut once. It's not too bad. Really.
It's a question.
I had a bagel once.
See, yeah, that's good.
Was your question, is it a fur-bearing animal?
That's what I asked.
Yes. No.
Okay. Five down.
It isn't an... May I assume that it is an animal of some sort?
Yes.
And is this animal a four-legged animal?
Yes.
Doesn't have fur, though. Would this animal have feathers?
No.
Six down.
A four-legged feathered animal?
Four-legged.
I don't know. What did I ask?
An animal that you can eat and dance with and is exotic. Wait, I'll get my hat and go with you.
I think I'm in love.
I am too. I'm mad about this, whatever it is. Is it of the fish or...
Fish with four legs?
I mean, aquatic.
That's a very good word.
Aquatic.
It has four legs.
We couldn't say no to that.
You couldn't say no. You couldn't say yes.
It's
aquatic.
Swims.
And you eat and you... I pass.
Why?
What?
Platypus.
Is it, now you say it has four legs. Is that what you admitted?
admitted under duress.
And you can hold it in your hand so it's not...
Well, you could. It's physically possible.
It's physically possible, yes. But I mean, it's not a rhinoceros. It's something you can hold in your hand.
Yeah.
All right. Is the skin used for anything?
Yes.
Well, I don't know what, but I suppose there's a use for it someplace.
You bet. If it's skin, there's a use for it. Is it, you say that it is aquatic. Can it live on land as well as in the water?
Yes.
It has no shell. Is it, no.
You want to pass? Pass.
I'm thinking.
Well, is it in the family like an otter or a mongoose or that type
of... An otter has fur, dear.
No.
An otter
Seven has down. Fur.
Is it, would it be in the reptile family?
Yeah.
Would it be something like a crocodile or some sort?
No,
you can hold it in your hand.
That's right. You can hold... Why did I ask?
Crabs don't have four legs.
Other than they women, what kind of legs do you
have? If you kiss it with a kiss...
Octopus
frog.
Legs.
Frog. 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 She imports frogs.
English. Oh, dear.
But Pat is co-owner of a frog farm in Costa Rica. How did you get into the frog business?
Well, I'm a market analyst, and I was surveying schools in the United States to find out what kind of educational equipment they would be wanting. And I learned that there was a major shortage of frogs for biology classes. And at that time, it really didn't mean very much to me. But later, I was in Costa Rica on another assignment, and I heard that somebody had started a farm there because they breed year-round in Costa Rica. They never hibernate. And so I got together with this man, and we went into business, and we breed frogs, and we sell them essentially for research and dissection and schools. And
how many do you sell a year, Pat?
Last year, we sold 1 million frogs.
A million?
A million, yes.
Gee.
How much do they sell for?
Between $2 and $5, injected with latex, different colors. We get $5 for them, and without the...
A little silicone.
That's a pretty big business, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, terrific. And I understand that frogs live a long period, too.
Yes, they live approximately 30 to 40 years.
And once they, find a mate?
Yes, they're very faithful. They mate for life.
I think the one you danced with was around.
That's right. That's just remember, they say a cat has 9 lives, but a frog croaks every day.
Well, Pat, we're delighted you could join us on Once My Line. Thank you so very much.
Thank you very much.
Say goodbye to the panel.
We'll be back to meet our mystery guest as What's My Line continues. Once again, panel, we've reached that very special part of What's My Line, the time we meet our mystery guests. So blindfolds in place, please. Are they securely in place?
Yes, sir.
Absolutely. I can't.
All right. Mystery challenger, will you enter and sign in, please? Panel, you know very well it's one question at a time. I'm going to give you 2 minutes to try and establish the identity of our mystery guest, and we'll begin with Jim Backus.
Have we been together the last few days?
Really?
What kind of question is that?
No. Arlene.
No, you haven't been with him. It is a him, I guess.
Are you known to audiences because of your work in motion pictures mostly? Primarily?
No, I wouldn't say so. No.
Soupy. Is he known primarily for his work in motion pictures? And our mystery guest responded, no.
Oh, well, are you best known, are you in something other than the, show business? Would you be a sports figure?
No, I am not.
Anita.
If it's an imitation, I don't get it. I don't get it at all.
Anita.
I know. Do you do television?
Well, I do television from time to time.
Jim?
You are a mimic.
Oh, I wouldn't exactly say that. Scott, I think he's got it.
Oh. It's Rich Little.
That's great.
Couldn't we have a little conversation between Mr. Magoo and Son?
Well, he's one of the few people who does me as me, I guess.
Do you remember what happened on Truth or Consequences? We went on Truth or Consequences together, and we tried to fool a lady. We had her blindfold into who is the real Mr. Magoo, and I won. I beat up.
Remember that?
Poor old Jim went home really dejected.
I thought I had it all.
They gave him a dancing frog beautiful. And he went away.
Yeah.
But you have another one of your marvelous albums coming out.
I'm working on an album this week called Politics and Popcorn. And it's got Nixon and Agnew and Humphrey and Johnson. Also got about 200 movie stars in it. And one of the cuts we have Nixon and Agnew playing ping pong. And Nixon beats Agnew in ping pong. And then there's this terrific crash, and Nixon says, "Spiro, how many times do I have to tell you? You only jump over the net to congratulate the winner in tennis, not ping pong." I also do Johnny Olson.
This is Johnny Olson, the fun and sun capital of the world, Miami Beach.
He said if I did that on the show, he'd give me a free meal in the commissary.
Which wasn't the best offer you'll ever have.
But I did it anyway.
But, Rich, you have a remarkable talent, and we're so delighted with your success.
Thank you, Wally. Last time I was on the show, Jim was on, and I did him. And you guessed it, too.
Last time I was there was at our house. You were
That's right. Yeah. That great party, yeah.
Sing for us.
sing.
As we leave.
Everybody.
They're giving me the time to. All right. Thank you, Rich Little.
Yes, big boy.
What's My Line? We'll continue right after this word. May I say again today, you were brilliant.
Well, thank you.
Yeah, no, I was three for three.
Were
Mr.
you three
Rich
for three?
Was.
No, we didn't get the frogs.
No, see what happens tomorrow to the frogs, won't you please, on What's My Line?
We find.
Prizes or product mentions were furnished and or paid for by the manufacturers or suppliers of the products or services identified on this program.